first game jitters are gone now, Dick. Both of these teams are looking to settle into their comfort zone in this second round matchup between the Boston University Terriers and the Florida Gators.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Gators should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. Number one, the point guard has to be the leader out there. He's got to be the coach on the floor. Next, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. And lastly, don't get away from what got you here on defense. Don't try and do too much defensively.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Looks at the three. Off the rim and no good.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
He's in three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position and spreading his body and getting the ball. Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Contact causes the shot to come off. Dumps it in. Tries for two. And in and out. They look to get it to the inside. Good fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
There's the block. Way off target. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Leans in. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
There's the screen up on top.
He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Number 15 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Throws it up. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. The shooting guard gets the ball. A high screen. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
The small forward with the ball. He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team, get in the flow.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Number 15 gets the pass. He unloads a three.
They're having a rough time getting it on the drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
Trying to feed inside. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Got to eliminate those turnovers.
Dickey's going to go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad, before the game, the coaches told us their only worry was their team getting down too early. Now that this team has, the players are trying very hard not to panic and put it all together.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Second one, no good. He gets the board.
Trying to go inside.
The center takes the pass. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Number 25 fakes the shot.
Ooh, look at a shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
Perfectly executed. He's got a nice shot fake. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. He takes the board. The Gators' success on the gridiron is usually what garners the most attention.
They definitely receive a lot of football support, but it's great to see the same folks at the basketball games.
They move it into the front court. Number 24 is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Number 31. Basket's good, and he got a little charity for his effort.
Hey, he did a good job of keeping himself under control despite the foul.
Number 31 going to the charity stripe for the first time tonight. No good. From right of the circle, way off target. Squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Number 41 steps in for the first half time.
This may or may not have been the right substitution at this point, Brad.
This is the first. Hits that one. Greener took the worst of that one. Stolen away. From the top of the circle, they just can't seem to get a nice look at the goal tonight.
They have to be patient on offense and find some easy hoops.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Gets it to go. He gets the rejection. The small forward takes the feed. He wants a three. That's good. You get another look at it in the lane. Takes the pass in the paint.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
And, Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Off the rim and no good.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. kicking back outside.
Nice fake.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Here they come with a double team to stop it. On the outside, there's a bad pass right to the defender. Looking for a good shot. Gave it up. The Terriers have a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
For two, Boston University is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Fakes it.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
Nice shot. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Up and inside.
Number 34 is eager and excited to compete.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Great play to take that to the basket.
Opportunity for two for one. Looking for a good shot. They've left him completely alone.
Double team now, bad angle.
Number 15 grabs it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He throws it up from downtown. Shot clock is dead. Now they'll bring it up. Stolen. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Tries for two.
I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. And now, why don't more guys use him?
At the half, the Terriers lead by three. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Is guilty of poor shooting in that first half, and I mean poor shooting, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, you're too nice a guy, I know that, but you're too kind. The Wolf was shooting, they're going through a wound with any ball games.
All right, Dick, we're going into the second half, and, you know, this gets down to somebody's going home and somebody gets to play on.
I'll tell you what, momentum's so important. You got to try to go on a little spurt now, because anybody that gets the lead is really putting the pressure on the club that would be behind.
Working around the perimeter on the dribble, gives it up. Pump fakes. There's a double team waiting there. Dick, are they being taken out of their game offensively?
Hey, they're taking themselves out of the game by rushing bad shots and not executing an offense.
He fires away. The Terriers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Big man spins down on the low block.
Does a great job getting the defense player to lean one way and spin back the other.
Point guard receives the ball. Goes up for two. And he missed. Tries for two. The point guard handles the pass. That That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The Terriers have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brady's on fire.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Gave it up. Cross court. There's a high screen.
Coming inside.
He takes the shot off the baseline. Off the rim and no good. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He attempts a three. No. The power forward handles the feed. Tries to turn. The defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. But good rebound position, a good.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He pump fakes. He fouled him. Full house. And a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
The power forward receives the pass. The ball handler might be in trouble here. The Terriers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
On the dribble, gives it up. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Gets it back out. On the outside. As the fans continue to chant.
I love it, Brad. Only in college basketball, baby. Only in college basketball.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, down here on the sidelines, both coaches are harping at their players, telling them it's all about the little things. Take care of the ball. Take quality shots. The action and intensity has really picked up down here, guys. Everyone wants to see a great finish.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Outside jumper. He gets it to fall.
A defensive stop would definitely get the fans out of their seats.
Controlling the ball. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Around the arc. perfectly executed. I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. And a momentary look from three-point land. Jumps into the defender, and he misses the shot. He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play. He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
For the deuce.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go.
Gave it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He does the sweet fake shot. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Number 13 draws the personal. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Number 21 makes the substitution back into the ballgame.
Well, Brad, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of energy he comes with.
First one, good. It. Steals the pass.
Line of ball, pressure, help side, it's all there.
He pump fakes. It's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
He takes the shot. He hits the shot.
We got to see that one again. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
He's open if he wants the shot. He takes the three, rims out. I think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in there.
Picked out of the air, pushes it up, picks off the pass. Timeout's been called. Let's check in with Aaron.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Count that as a personal foul. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
The fake. Number 34 with the fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Off the rim and no good. Again, a little one-man backcourt pressure. Pushes it. Length of the floor. There's the fake. Here's a double team.
Up and inside.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position, spreading his body and getting the ball.
And the ball goes out of bounds. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Number 34 is pounded on his way up. Look at him now, just enjoying the moment.
Hey, he's dancing, baby. A dancer. I never knew that. I'm surprised.
He'll go to the line. First one is good. He makes his second shot.
They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
Makes it. No doubt.
They need points on this possession, baby.
Switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Three-pointer. Rims out.
The offense can't get that break going.
These boys have really done their homework. Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Boston University is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.